Hello, and welcome to the Complete Beginner's Guide to Adobe Illustrator, brought to you by tastytutes.com. This is a course created for beginners to Adobe Illustrator. The topics that are going to be covered in this course are the basics, so whether you have the most up-to-date version of Illustrator or you're using an older version, you should be able to follow along just fine. For this course, I will be using Adobe Illustrator CC. In this series, we will be starting from the very beginning and working our way across 19 episodes to learn all the basics and create an illustration project. To help break down the process, I have structured the course in three main sections: introduction, essential practice, and test project. In the introduction section, I will be introducing you to Illustrator and bringing you up to speed with some of the things you need to be aware of before we continue on to the essential practice section. In the essential practice section, we are going to look closely at some of the creative tools and principles in Illustrator. Here, you will have the opportunity to get hands-on with the various worksheets I have designed and prepared for you to practice with. When we get to the test project section, we will be using all that we have learned in the essential practice section to create a project from scratch. After watching this series, you will be able to create your very own vector artwork ready to print. Now, if you wish to follow along with this course, you can download the entire project folder for free. The link is in the description. This folder contains all the worksheets, fonts, and project files necessary to follow along. If you wish to skip ahead or back at any point in the course, you can find every episode link in the descriptions of each video. Also, I suggest you download the PDF worksheet. You can save this to your computer and come back at any point. This is an interactive PDF which has been designed to enhance this course experience. This contains all the relevant video and project download links, so I recommend you download this PDF. And you can also find the download link for this in the description. So, what is Adobe Illustrator? Well, Adobe Illustrator is part of the Adobe Creative Suite, and in recent years has become industry standard for creating vector artwork and simple layouts for print. If you need to create logos, illustrations, posters, infographics, t-shirt designs, and flyers, Illustrator is a program to create them in. The tools in Illustrator make it very easy to create and modify shapes and strokes, to build your compositions and bring your design to life. You can also import pixel-based images to add to your layouts as part of your designs. So, what are we going to create on this course? Now, for all you artists, illustrators, and designers out there who love to draw and sketch on paper, hopefully this course is really going to help you. We are going to bring a hand-drawn sketch, which has been scanned and placed into Illustrator and converted into vector artwork. Then we are going to use this vector artwork in a poster and t-shirt design. So, why a t-shirt and poster design? Well, we are going to explore a scenario where we are going to design for print. So, we are going to be working with CMYK colors for the poster, though for the t-shirt design, we will need to stay within a budget and use only Pantone colors that the printer requires. So we are going to explore how to incorporate Pantones and CMYK swatches into our artwork. So let's take a look at the finished document. So here we are in Adobe Illustrator, and here you are looking at the finished artwork document we are going to build up to. So this document consists of four artboards. The first two artboards contain the development stages in our project, and the last two artboards contain the finished designs. On artboard 1, we have a vector drawing composition, which was traced from a sketch drawing, which was scanned and placed into our document. This complex composition contains multiple shapes and stroke vectors. On artboard 2, we have the same artwork, but this is a single flat vector. The artwork from the first artboard has been compounded into a single vector here. On artboard 3 is the finished poster artwork. Here we have lots of colors, gradient effects, and type objects. On the last artboard is the t-shirt design, And here we can also see our Pantone references, which we are going to use to incorporate correct Pantone colors into our artwork. Once we have finished the poster and t-shirt design, we are then going to export the artwork to the correct format for a printer to print the design to specification. Here are two PDFs we are going to finish with. If we look carefully at the first PDF on the left, we can see that this is just one page, and we can see a number of marks and guides around the outside. Now, these are bleed and crop marks that the printer is going to use to correctly trim the artwork. Also, we have some color squares to help the printer collaborate the colors accurately with their printers. All these marks and guides have been generated upon exporting the artwork from the Illustrator document, and we will be taking a look at how to do this at the end of the course. Over to the right, we have the t-shirt artwork PDF. Now, this is a little different from the poster example. This artwork is going to be printed onto a t-shirt. So we can see here that the artwork is set on a white background, and some of the color in the skull artwork is also white. This is where the color of the t-shirt is going to come through and fill these areas. Notice, on this example, we do not have any marks and bleeds. Well, this design is not going to be printed on paper. This will become a transfer that will be heat pressed onto a t-shirt, so we do not need marks and bleeds here. So that is everything we are going to build up to on this course. So once you have downloaded the project folder, let's get into it. And we are going to begin with the first video in the course, Interface Introduction to Adobe Illustrator. So I'll see you in the next video.